What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Hustle with Jesse W, and today we nailed it again. Check it out. Well, guys, today was a good day. In the morning, we nailed HCWB, we nailed Tesla, and had some really good trades. So once again, trading a small cap, you know, gapper that was making some moves this morning, and then going over to Tesla and getting some call options there. So it's been a really good day, and I've been able to show you again how being a diversified trader is so important, right? If you only trade like $2, $3, $4, $5 stocks because you think that's all you can trade, then you miss out tremendously, right? So in this video, I'm gonna show you my trades on both of these stocks. I'm gonna show you the chart. I'm gonna show you where I entered, where I exited. I'm gonna also go over the plan and the idea behind the trade, all right? And I'll show you the alerts that we put up here in the Discord. Now, if you don't know, we've opened up that free Discord we talked about a while back. I put up a poll here and I asked you guys if you would be interested in a free Discord, and well, you said yes. So we went ahead and did it. So there's a link in the description and in the comment sections for you to come join us in the free Discord. All right. Now there's many different facets to that Discord. Once you come on in, you'll see what it's all about. Now let's go ahead and jump into the video.
It's recap time. And what we're going to do is recap today's trades. So let me grab the watch list for you real quick. Watch list: HCWB, 12.4 million shares in the float, receives FDA clearance to proceed with phase 1B, watching for 470s to hold support on pullbacks, could have room towards 620 to 780s. All right, that's the level I was eyeing this morning. Those were the levels I was looking at. IFRX, DBGI, DATS, and Tesla all on watch. Tesla on watch for 1065 area to hold support, 11 for a chance of an attack of $1,100 zone. All right, so with those levels on watch and those tickers on watch, we started off our day. First trade of the day for me was HCWB. HCWB has been a tough trade, no doubt about it. This thing has not been easy, but I'll tell you what, small caps has not been easy the last 2 days, 3 days maybe. We've been getting some really nice moves, but they're short-lived. We're not getting that continued move in the afternoon either. Yesterday I was eyeing some for the afternoon trades. They didn't fulfill, so no trades in the afternoon. But this morning, right, HCWB held that line we drew in pre-market right here. You can see it in the 470s, and just bang, right off that level. Next level to watch, I said, was in the 540s, right? Was in the 540s. So when we got halted here in the morning at 640, what did I say? I got on the mic and I said, guys, I'm going to be watching HCWB out of the halt to see if we get a pullback into that zone, right? Because momentum, chart pattern, all coupled together, how could I say no? So out of the halt, you know, I was actually hoping we would open up flat and dip in like right away, you know, but we didn't. We actually opened up a little bit above, and then we pushed a little bit higher, and then bang, we slammed all the way back down here. And when I saw this happen, you know, we got down here to the 560s. I said, okay, I know my level's in the 540s. And I know this thing is going to have a spread. I know this thing's going to have a lot of people FOMOing into it. So I'm going to keep eyes on it and see if we see a lot of buying coming into it. We get all the way down there. I see some buying coming in, and I go ahead and get long HCWB 589. And where do I set my stop? So 589 entry, and I got it really nice. All right, so 589 entry in that circle, and I set my stop in the 530 area. Why the 530 area? Well, because 540s is the daily level, okay? 540s is this previous high right in here, 540s, 550s, and the 23.6 Fibonacci level, right? So I'm long from here, my stop is there. Boom, this thing goes right through the high of day, you know, gets a nice move, goes even higher in the next candle, and I just started taking some profits off. So I take some profits off at 680, okay? So I take some profits off 680. I take more profits off at 695 over here, 695s. All right. And then I hold on to some, looking to see if we were going to get one of these and get halted again. That would have been monstrous, but we don't. We kind of start getting rejected there, all right? I took off the bulk of my position up here, and then we get a quick little drop. And right in here at 603, I get flat, okay? I get flat at 603 right there from my entry in here. All right, so that was it right there. That was a nice trade. Obviously, like I said, it was way faster than I would have ever wanted it to be. And also, it was a little bit more of an advanced trade because it was extremely fast. It was an extremely fast trade, okay? And it was very early on in the day. So entry, take profit, flat. And then what do we talk about after that? We talk about the potential double bottom setup. Look at the move we get all the way up here. What happened? I got back on the mic and I said, guys, this is why I always take profits off in front of the high of day, just in case it holds up as resistance and you get a nasty double top. Imagine if you're like, oh, double bottom, bet. Let me get long. You get long in there and then you don't take any profits off up here because you're like convinced it's going to tear through the high of day. High of day was 705. We're going to tear through the high of day, go to $8, right? Then you're stuck holding your entire position here because you refuse to take some profits off. This is, as I was saying it, guys, I was saying it right here. Guys, it's always a good idea to take some profits off up here, the way I teach, the way I trade, because you never know when you're going to get a dump candle, and then bang, you got a dump candle, right? So, you know, live and learn, right? Next, next trade for me was Tesla. Now, Tesla has the makings of potential afternoon squeeze if Tesla likes to squeeze during lunchtime, which I hate, but it has the potential for an afternoon squeeze if it continues trading sideways here. Right here, I was telling you guys, hey, I'm watching Tesla for a break of VWAP and a hold of that level as support. And what did we get? We got the break. We already saw that. And then we started to get that pullback. Right? We started to get that pullback. Went ahead, got long some calls. Right there, long Tesla, $1,100 calls, tomorrow's expiration, 845. Stop if Tesla gets under 1065 VWAP area. There's your VWAP area, there's your 1065, your level right here on the 15-minute chart that we eyed. You know, get the pullback, boom, get the calls. And I said, I'm not looking for a huge trade on Tesla, I'm just looking to pad the wallet, you know, small trade. We got a little pop, take some profit, taking some profits, 980, right? We get a quick little push higher, taking some more profits, 990. And then I said, okay, I'm gonna hold the remainder near break even. We start to get that pullback and I get flat at 870, okay? And that was it, nice little wallet patter on the day. So 2 for 2 on the day, and that's it for me. That's all I need. It's a really good day here. It has been a difficult trading day, but when you come in with the mindset of, I'm going to take what the market gives me, then you're able to take what the market gives you. You know, it's just really that's the way it is. You're going to take what the market gives you. You're not going to impose your will on the market because we are not stronger than the market. All right, guys, so that concludes the recap on the morning. And I'm going to stick around here for a little while longer, then break off into lunch. I'll be back around 2 o'clock. But in the meanwhile, if you have any questions, drop them in chat. Love talking stocks.
Well, guys, that's it for me today. It's a little windy out here. Going to go ahead and enjoy the afternoon. Then I'm going to get back in chat for the afternoon lessons and the afternoon scans. All right. If you enjoyed this video, remember to smash the like button for me. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't. And I'll catch you on the next one.